Hey everyone, so I had a special request to look at the Niang 22 and 33 by Bilibili. This was the Chinese New Year Festival 2021 edition. And so I'm going to go ahead and show them close up, and also about some of the inspiration that was applied to the Alex Kuno Tool print as a result of this figure. So we'll just go ahead and spend a couple of minutes going over this. Basically, as you can see here, we've got 22 on the left, 33 on the right. Both of these are just beautifully composed. You can just see the absolutely gorgeous face detail, the metallic sheen of the dress that they composed for her. She's lounging on the, I think it's what called a chaise lounge. Her shoes off to the side here. Cushion. Crane in the back here. Blossoms on the branch extending, which you'll see was drawn as inspiration for my custom remarque in the Alex Kuno print. Then on 33, let's start up here. Again, just gorgeous details on the hands, face, all around. I just love the remarkable detail they actually put into these. The ornate design in the back there. The desk with the integrated mirror. As you can see, it is an actual mirror. And I think it's a plastic frame, but it certainly presents wood-like in that regard. Now, because the dresses are metallic, they definitely can collect some dust. That said, I've really only had to remove dust a couple of times so far, and it was just easily done. So don't let that be too much of a deterrent. And again, these were actually, I knew I was going to display them by the Alex Kuno print. Which this particular tool print to me actually represents a peeling back of the layers to one's true self. And so basically the custom remark that he did on this, if you've seen the other print or if you look at other references, you'll see the what's clinging to the left and right side almost like it's falling away. He did that with a special translucence. And then I had asked him, since I knew I was going to have 22 and 33 by it, to try and draw some type of elements from it that would intertwine into it. And what Alex did was he basically brought in the branch, weaved through, and down behind partially. So one other thing, I feel like this wouldn't be fully complete unless I rotate their views, which I have to do rather carefully, as you can tell. This will give a good look at some of the detail that probably is not shown all the time. So that's side view. Let's get a closer look at this. Try and get the lighting a little better here. You can see there is a lot of depth to the figure in general. Like I said, the details really are just fantastic overall. Let's set her back and we will rotate 33 into view. There you have 22 and 33. See, I've also got it by the Peach Momoko, and I've got 4 of my 5 Ukiyo-e woodblock prints above that. My Adi Granoff, my Alan Williams, which also has a custom remark. And I've also got my Salt Lake one. Let's not forget the Cool Fetus. Tomei. Taya. Number of my favorites right above here. But you can really see just how, at least for me, 22 and 33 really stand out. They really just have exceptional detail. And I'm actually getting ready to shift some things around, I think, which may move 22 and 33 back up here, along with Ningguang. So, that's just at least a quick little look at 22 and 33. Some of the art remark that was inspired by them and brought in for them, and just some of my other collectibles.